before we dive into thinking more about volume and length and things, let's just focus a bit more on area. So let's find the area inside here. This orange curve is the graph y equals x squared, and this red line is just the horizontal line y equals 1. So I want to figure out the area of this region, which is below the red line and above the orange curve. We already know how to attack a problem like this. I take this region and I cut it up into vertical strips, right? I want to imagine cutting it up into a whole bunch of thin rectangles. And then I just want to add up the areas of those rectangles, integrate. Well, to set up the integral, I should say pick a value of x and think now, how tall is this thin rectangle? Well, the top edge of the rectangle is at 1, and the bottom edge is at x squared. So the height of this rectangle here, say, is 1 minus x squared. That's the length here. What's the width? Well, I'm just going to call that dx, right? I'm imagining that these rectangles are real thin. So now the area of just this one rectangle is 1 minus x squared, that's its height, times its width dx. But I don't just want the area of this one rectangle, I want to add up the areas of all these rectangles, so I'm going to integrate this from x goes minus 1 to 1, right? And I get those endpoints by thinking about how small and how large x can be in this region. So I'll put a minus 1 and a 1 there, and this definite integral will calculate the area of this region. And I can calculate that definite integral, right? Let me just copy it down here. So the integral that I want to calculate is the integral x goes from minus 1 to 1 of 1 minus x squared dx. And to calculate that integral, it's enough to use the fundamental theorem of calculus. So I'll write down an antiderivative. X minus x cubed over 3 is an antiderivative. And then the fundamental theorem of calculus tells me to evaluate this at 1 and at minus 1 and take the difference. So I'll plug in 1 and I get 1 minus 1 cubed over 3. And I'm going to subtract what I get when I plug in minus 1, which is minus 1 minus minus 1 cubed over 3. But what's this? This is 1 minus a third, that's 2/3, minus minus 1 plus a third, which is negative 2/3. And 2/3 minus negative 2/3 is 4/3. So the area of this region is 4/3 square units. But I could also do this by cutting the region up into horizontal strips. So here I am cutting this region up into some horizontal rectangles, which instead of being thin in terms of their width, they're now thin in terms of their height. I just want to add up all of these not very tall rectangles to compute the area of this region. So to do that, I'm going to pick some value of y, and I'm going to think about, for that value of y, how wide is that rectangle? Well, let's think about this point over here, right? This is the curve y equals x squared. So for this value of y, what's the corresponding value of x? Well, it's the square root of y. And that tells me how wide this whole rectangle is, right? This point over here is negative the square root of y. So from here to here is 2 square roots of y. That's the width of this rectangle. Let me write that down. So I've got the width of the rectangle is 2 square roots of y. Now how tall is that rectangle? Well, let's call that dy, right? I'm imagining that the rectangle isn't very tall, really thin. So the product, 2 square root of y, its width, and its not very tall height, dy, that gives me the area of one of these thin rectangles, and I'm going to integrate that, but from where to where? Well, y could be as small as 0 and as big as 1. So this integral will calculate the area of this region decomposed into horizontal strips. Now I just got to do that integral, but I can definitely do that, right? I can do this integral by using the fundamental theorem of calculus. Let me just copy that integral down over here. I'll be integrating from 0 to 1 2 square roots of y dy. Now let me rewrite that as the integral from 0 to 1 of 2y to the 1/2 power dy. And now I can write down an antiderivative of this by using the power rule. So an antiderivative is 2y to the 3/2 power divided by 3/2. Right, an antiderivative of y to a power is y to one more than that power divided by one more than that power. And I want to evaluate that at 0 and at 1 and take the difference. Well, when I plug in 1, I get 2 over 3 over 2. When I plug in 0, I get 0. So the answer is 2 divided by 3 over 2, which I can rewrite as 4/3, which is the area of this region. The neat thing here is that either way, we're getting the same answer. And I think this is more amazing than it seems at first. I mean, look, when I cut it into horizontal strips, I ended up wanting to calculate this integral, the integral y goes from 0 to 1, 2 square roots of y dy. And when I cut the region up into these vertical strips, I wanted to do the integral x goes from minus 1 to 1 of 1 minus x squared dx. But these two integrals end up being equal because they're both calculating the area of the same region. They're both calculating 4 over 3 square units.